Okay, great. So now here I am. I have, for the first time, I got the books back. What do you call them? They're supposed to be the proofs, but I don't have time for proofs. But so anyway, so I got the books, and they're bigger, wide. Well, each one is about 100 pages. So I'm kind of impressive. This is the European Journeys one. This is my philosophy book and photography. There I am, Therese de la Fontaine. And there's my little sweet sheep there. There's all my photos, all my images that I've taken, my animals. So it's kind of that type of, like a photo essay, but then it's also a philosophy book also of my life. While I was on Corsica, okay? So, I won't go on and on and on about the book and give it to you, but it is very expensive. All of these are about $22, because that's just the cost if I want to list them in the Scholastic School pool or the Barnes & Noble pool, you know, the mainstream pool. So that I have to shoot them up there for my $1. I think I get a dollar if you buy it. Even from 22, so that's the way it goes. But anyway, that one. And then there's little Wu in Rudy at the bottom. There. Now, a few of the inks came out a little red. That's life. And no, there's not a hardback. This was only like a paperback company. So if it's a paperback company, this creates space. It means it's more manual. Like a manual, yeah. Okay, now Gallery Therese. Now this one actually came out pretty much okay. I'm like, wow, who's that artist? Oh my gosh, she's amazing. And so off it goes, all the art and poetry of mine. And you can't see. I'm not going to let you see it. And there's the back of it. And again, there I am, Therese de la Fontaine. And this is paintings and poetry. So I have poems inside. Each little escapade has a poetry, most of them anyway. Pretty much every painting has a poem associated. And I think I'm a pretty good poet. Yeah, I think that was easy for me. That was easy. But anyway, that's a really cool book, actually. I'm like really impressed by myself. And now we have Stones of the Gods. Now this one is the kicker, we're gonna call it, you know, because the Stones of the Gods are like, this is about zoolatry. This is about the way we were before Christianity, before Catholicism, before Judea, before any Islamic anything. This was us. We were zoolatry people. So it's all about the stones these are in Corsica. Now this is my finding. This goes back to the dragon also. I have the dragon in there and a lot of other things. But anyway, so when it goes to the rocks, I know I can't really show it right now. It doesn't show very good, but yeah. Yeah, when it goes to the rocks, they're all there, and I catalog them as you know, this is here and this is there and that's the other, and they're all carvings in there, and well, they're not all carvings, but anyway, it's a very interesting find. It's an archaeology find, and. There's one moment of it there. You can see this wounding character, this god character here. His head, you see his head? And there's my dog. So you can see the size difference between the wounding character. He's actually a large giant caterpillar from ancient times. He's a caterpillar. That's my guesstimate. Because I've seen another caterpillar that's his size also, and he's in the book. They're all in the book. So it's kind of a wow, kind of fun thing. It's hot here. I'm just sweating. And yeah, the ocean dragon is in here. I have him out there on the very back. You can see here, that's his head. And then and there's the rivets of his spine. So he's quite a big character, considering that only a human being is only like there near him. So yeah, he's a needle. And you see, you get cl I get closer in the book. And then all along here, you see this? These are all carved. All of these are characters that are all carved through the years. So we have a big raven, a big rook. We have an owl. We have a little baby hyena over here, and then we have like a tiger. There's a tiger statue in the middle there. So it's really something else. There's a large duck, reptile here next to him, and then right there is like a giant caterpillar. So we have a whole bunch of characters in there that are just like, from when did they happen? I don't know. I'm guessing 50 million years ago. Yeah. So that was a long time ago. Okay. But then in the interim, they were carved and honed and shaped. Yeah. So giant things are there. Okay. Now, and there's also like an old pharaoh head, an old Cheops. I say Cheops, but there were others. There were others. Okay, so now this one is the flower power. This is flower power with Therese. Now this is about, what did I say? Painting inspiration, art styles, and musings from a flower child. This is like a syllabus. Like, don't forget to teach your children these techniques. Okay, so that's what this is all about. This is a technique book. From little child all the way to grandiose, hey, I'm going to college. So yeah, that's what this book is all about. And yet it's a little past. It has a little past association with being a flower power child. Here I am. This is my artwork even on the cover. Isn't that cute? You know, so I was a whacked out abstract flower child right away. And then so there. And now this book actually really came out the best color wise. Like all the colors are really bright and vivid. So it has that, you know, that effect. You know, even the marbled, yeah. So it gives it you know, it's funner to read. You know, so this is really for teachers, but this could be for homeschooler moms or dads. This can be for anybody who really just is like, wait a minute, maybe I need that for my art progression as a human. Maybe I just want to read it. And I do talk a little bit, a little documentary-ish show. So it's I have a few of my little characters in there. So anyway, it's kind of fun. It's kind of a fun book because it represents childhood of this flower power era. Tantria. And so here we are, and I'm still at ancient stones from a time when dragons roamed the world, and that's what I wrote. Isn't that neat that I'm that person? I'm the author who said that. That's what's really cool when you get your books back. And then they put like this little ding thing at the back, like a scan code. I'm like, yeah, cool. I can be scanned now. But yeah, and all these little words are mine. And then I'm like, wait a minute. This is really mean process, self-publishing, because I'm here at this computer all by myself, and then I got a couple words wrong, and there's no way I can send that up again and again and again. It's just impossible. So I just give up. I just give up. That's it. What you see is what you get. So I'm a self-publisher. Ooh, look at that vicious stone head right there. Look at that character. Now he's as large as about three or four cars. He's that big, on top of a mountain. The skull, the dog skull. Ooh. Yeah, they were into something, weren't they? You can imagine. You can see almost the teeth. You can see the teeth there, how they're all dug out. Yeah, they were into some kind of. They were putting candles up there and worship. Something to do with the sea and the sky for sure. But yeah, so it's kind of like. And nobody wrote a book about it yet. Just me. I'm the first one. So yeah, that's kind of cool. So I feel like the guy who discovered the Egypt pyramids in a way. Remember him? He discovered the pyramids, and he was some whitey guy from Britain. And of course, all the Egyptians knew about the pyramids, but he discovered them according to Britain. And he ran back, and he got all this acclaim, you know. So here I am. I'm running back. I'm running back to English speak land with all the acclaim. You know, I discovered this. Like, see this guy? This is a guy right here on a cliff. And he has two animals on his head, you know, on either side, so they help him see. He's actually blind. He's a blind god. He uses the animals to help him see. So anyway, so yeah, he was in a movie. It was in a movie. This is awful because they've changed my internet. I can't just upload now. I have to like get. I make the video now. I have to compress it, and that'll take me about an hour. So this is just no fun. They just take the fun out of everything, don't they? Any hoot. Any hoot. Yeah, I don't know. I had some really wonderful yogi things to say. But not in this video. I'll try to bring it back and come through with it again because it doesn't really represent with these. It wasn't anything to do with these. Nothing. You sure you don't want to read my philosophy book? That's actually, oh, we don't know if we like you now. You know, it's that kind of book. If you watch my vlogs, I'm sure you would say that also. Anyway, my cork tree, he did not come out as well as I wanted. You see him? He's a man. He's a cork tree man. But it really is a tree. You see his face? He's alive. He's alive. I love him. He's my I call him my Tannenbaum cork tree, this fellow. Yeah. Those trees are definitely alive. And I'm actually against them taking the corks and putting them on the bottles because of him. He grew like that on his own, you know, in the face of man. He just looks like, hey, I'll look right like you, pal. You know, I listen to you all day, I'll just look like you. How about that? So there he is. And gosh dang it, it came out a little too dark, but he really does look like a man. Anywho, my little chickens, I love them and I will miss them forever. I will miss them forever. Gosh dang it. That was when I lived at, I don't, come on, what's the name? It wasn't Montfage, it was another place. It was another place. It was a beautiful estate. And these little sweethearts. They were there guarding it with me. I got to sing opera there in the little pigeonnière, and we guarded the estate, and we what else did we do? I guess we ran though that those mowers, and that, yeah, we mowed a little bit. Yeah, we did that. But oh my gosh, the love. I even have the love photo caught here. This is Igor and Petunia. Those two, they were in love. He never did that with the other ones. He had two other hens, and they're right there on the bench also. They're waiting next to be in love, but they never had that same mere mimic. They would mere mimic each other all the time and look real close into each other's eyes. you know, that adore, adore, you know, amor, amor, adore. Just so silly. I mean, and this hand, this one hand, she is was like the most beautiful hand in the world, I think. A little petunia. Like golden, like a golden hen. So any hoots. So I have my book. Oh my gosh, I'm very excited. You know, so I got a lot of photos in this one, but then it's also philosophy, you know, strewn through. I'm going to drag you through it, whether you want to hear it or not, or read it or not. And everything is large print. I went large, large print. You see how large that is? Tantatian. Yeah, large. So, that's that. And what a varied, varied grouping of books to all of a sudden have. So if you're into archaeology, if you're into art, if you're into philosophy, if you're into travel, if you are into, if you have children and you're learning art. Yeah, so that's where I'm at. Oh my gosh, happiness. Happiness. See that? That's me. That's how I paint. Sometimes. Not always. That's special. Those are yellow wildflowers. And it says, wildflowers yellow, faint-hearted before, tell us you love each other forevermore. And that's it. That's my poem. I didn't even like practice it either. I should, huh? Da-da-da-da. Oh, it was a before more. Yeah, I do a lot of rhyming. Is that obnoxious? Tell us you love each other forevermore. Oh my God. Don't you love words sometimes? Like that? Just tell us. Isn't that something to like hold on to and sink into and go, yes, oh my God. Now that's substantial. That's substantial, isn't it? That. Just tell us. We need to know it. We need that determination. We need that just yes. That yes power, that no power, that there, it's in there, you know, we have that understanding. Oh my God, I almost got biblical there. I better watch it here now. Where am I? The Southwest? I'm not sure where I am yet. But anyway, yeah. A few lovey-dovey poems in here. But I'm very happy with this one. Yeah, poetry. This is poetry. Okay, so that blasts me into poetress. Okay, I will let go on this superhighway for a while until I can remember what I was supposed to yogi to everybody. Unless it was just that forevermore thing. No, there's more to that. There's more. There was a lot more. It was something really, really serious.